Hey guys, welcome back to the Sprinkles and Jam YouTube channel. This video is going to be about getting your photos ready for Etsy or your website or wherever you want to post them. And if you like this video or it helps you out, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe so that way you can be up to date on weekly videos. So let's get started. So typically I like to use Photoshop to edit my photos, but I also like to use like a quick online editor if I just want to do something really quick, like brighten up a photo. PicMonkey, if you want a subscription, has some really great features. You can see I kind of have some spots here on my table. You can edit those out in PicMonkey. But if you just want to do something really quick, want a free photo editor, we're going to use Canva. So you go to canva.com/photo-editor/app, and the links to everything will be down low in the description box. So I already have my photo imported in, and you can see that it came in sideways. So we're going to click this cropping icon here, and we're going to hit to rotate it to the right. Then we want to go ahead and hit this filter icon, and this is where we're going to brighten the photo up. So there is a next step that I'm going to show you guys where you can adjust the photo here. But if you just only need to brighten up your photo, then you can just use this photo editor and make these changes. So once you kind of have it a little bit brighter to the way that you like, you can kind of see my shadow over here from where I was taking the picture overhead has kind of lightened up a bit. Then you're good to go. You can go ahead and click save and download your image, and you're all done. So this next step is completely optional. I'm just adding this step in for those people who maybe don't have a lot of physical props at home and you want to add digital props into your photo. So we're just going to go to canva.com. You want to click create a design and choose custom dimensions. And I would start with maybe 1200 by 1000 pixels in height. That's usually a good place to start. The only downside is that if you start at this height and you find that it's not the right size, and I'll show you here, there's a little crown icon here. It means if you want to resize your image, you have to be a subscriber. So it may take a little bit of trial and error, but just try which size you like and then you should be good to go. Another thing I forgot to mention is I took my photo in portrait mode, but you want to use landscape. That way you have a lot of room on the side. So when we get to the step where we're adding a logo or props, things like that, you have more room to play around with. So as you can see, I already have some random elements in my picture. And this is just to kind of give you an idea of how you can make your image a little more unique, so it's different than other photos on Etsy or wherever you're uploading your photos at. So for example, if this were maybe like a beach tee, you could throw some flip-flops in there, have them kind of overlaying the photo, cut off in the corner, or put them all the way in. If you were doing more of a rustic design, you can throw in a plant. For a baby onesie, let's see if we can get rid of these. A teddy bear is great if you want to size that up and add that in a corner and throw in maybe a baby binky. You have a lot of like different ways that you can play around with it. So once you've kind of gotten your elements however you want them, you can go ahead and come up here and choose the download button. Normally they're going to suggest a PNG, which is fine for Etsy or Amazon. Those platforms are going to compress the image for you, so you don't really have to worry about the size. If you're getting this for your website, I would recommend going with a JPEG. That way you don't have a lot of images that are really heavy and making your site load slowly, because that's gonna like, you know, have some issues with Google ranking your site, crawling your site, and that kind of thing. So that's it for now. Once you have it the way you want it, go ahead and download your image and you're good to go. If you guys have any questions, please comment down below. And don't forget to check the description box for a link to our private Facebook group for small shop tips and new product launches. See you next time, and thanks for watching.